All right, this is Susan Haynes, and we're in November 2011. I would like to now step through this fast Fourier transform. The recursive version of the fast Fourier transform is given by Korman, Leisersohn, Rivest, and Stein in the Introduction to Algorithms book. And to make it concrete, we'll pick an A vector. So we'll say we'll use size 4. So A is A0, A1, A2, A3. Okay, n is clearly not 0, so I will not be returning at this point. I need to compute right here the principal 4th root of unity, n equals 4, so I need to compute n sub 4, the principal root, equals, it's given right here what it equals, e to the 2 pi I, pi I divided by 4, which equals e to the pi divided by 2 times I, which equals I. And we can tell that because here is, first of all, the radius is 1. We can see it's 1 times e. So the radius is 1. So it'll be on the unit circle. And then, so there's 1 right there. Okay. And then the angle that we're looking for the particular number in my polar coordinate system is pi over 2. And here is that angle right there. So it goes to that point right there. Okay, we will initialize omega to 1, but we're not going to use it till we get down to this part. Okay, first thing I do is divide my coefficients into even coefficients and odd coefficients. So we'll get even coefficients right here underlined. So I get A0, A2. That'll be that A, and then A1, A3 will be the A sup 1. Okay, I need to call the fast Fourier transform on that A sup 0. So I'm calling the fast Fourier transform on this right here. So now this is A right here. Length is not 1, so I will need to compute the square principal root of unity. We already know that from grade school. That equals minus 1. But if you want to go ahead and calculate it with the e to the 2 pi I divided by 2 or e to the pi I equals minus 1. That's great. Okay, so now I need to divide this into even coefficients and odd coefficients. Let me once again underline the even coefficients. This time there's only one of them. Don't let this number right here fool you. This is my new vector A. This is the 0th element. This is the 1th element. I'm just tracking the values down. This is no longer referring to the coefficient. This is position. This is referring to the value. Okay, so that'll give me my A sup 0 and my A sup 1 right there. So I need to compute the fast Fourier transform of these two things, n equals 1, so that's my base case, so I just return. So this is my Y sup 0, and this is my Y sup 1. Okay, a similar thing will go on here, so let me just pretend like I actually took my time to step through it, okay? That's dividing them into even and odd coefficients, calling the fast Fourier transform on them, and I get A1 and A3. This is my Y sup 0 and my Y sup 1. Okay, so now I have Y sup 0 and Y sup 1. I'm right here in my code, and I can see that n equals 2, because I'll be computing a final Y vector of size 2, so n equals 2. So this is the principal unit of unity I'm looking at. Let's start with k equals 0, and I'm going to go up to k less than or equal to 2 divided by 2 minus 1 is 0. So I'll only be going through this loop exactly once. Okay, y sub k, so y sub 0, I'm making my new y right here, and the 0th element is y sub 0 sup 0. So y sup 0 is here. This is the 0th element, so that's A0. Plus omega, which is 1, right there, plus 1 times y sup 1 sub 0. Y sup 1 is here. There's my 0th element, A2. Okay, and then I'm computing, still in that loop, y sub k plus 1, so that'll be my next element right here, is y sup 0 sub 0. Y sup 0 sub 0 gives me A0 minus omega minus 1 times y sup 1 sub 0. Okay, zero. Zeroth element right there is A2. Okay, so there is the this right here, A0 plus A2. A0 minus A2 is the Fourier transform of A0, A2. Okay, I can step through and do this similarly. Let me just race through again and pretend like I'm actually doing it. I'll just follow the pattern right here. So this is A1 plus 1 times A3. And then this first element is A1 minus 1 times A3. This is A2. Make it nice and clear. So I have computed the Fourier transform of this vector, A0, A2, is this 2 vector right here. Better make my parentheses look pretty, huh? And the Fourier transform of this vector right here, which is this 2 vector right here. Now I need to combine these two vectors into my final 4 vector. This was my y0 for the combining into the 4 vector. This is my y sup 1 for combining into the 4 vector. Okay, so at this point, my k is going to start at 0. My omega starts at 1, and I've already computed, obviously I've already computed my omega, but I've already computed my fourth principal root up here equals I. Okay, now when I go into this loop, k will start at 0, and it will go up to 4 divided by 2 minus 1. That equals 1. 4 divided by 2 is 2. 2 minus 1 is 1. So I'm going to only go through this loop twice. And every time I'm in the loop, I will compute two elements. So for the k equals 0, I will compute the 0th element here of my y and my 2 element, 0 plus 2, my 2 element. Okay, so let's start to create my y. And I'm going to label, sort of index my numbers so it makes it a little easier to read in this style. Okay, so I've got k0. So y sub k, that'll be this element here I'm computing, is y sup 0 sub 0. Y sup 0 sub 0 is this one right here. So that's a0 plus 1 times a2 plus omega, omega is 1, times y sup 1 sub 0. Y sup 1 sub 0, that's a1 plus 1 times a3. a1 plus 1 times a3. Okay, so that's the 0th element. Now I'm computing my 2 element, right? 0 plus 2. So that's y sup 0 sub 0. Y sup 0 is here, sub 0 is here. So that's a0 plus 1 times a2. Minus omega minus 1 times y sup 1 sub 0. Sup 1 sub 0, that's this one right here. A1 plus A3. A1 plus 1 times A3. Okay, update my omega. It is 1 times I. So my omega goes to I. So k goes to 1. And I'm going through my loop once more. So now I have y sub 1. So I'll be computing for this element right here equals y sup 0 sub 1. Y sup 0 sub 1 is this one, a0 minus a2. Okay, plus omega, that's plus I, times y sup 1 sub 1. Y sup 1 sub 1, that's this element right here, a1 minus a3. Okay, and then I have y sub k plus 2, it is y sub 3, so I'll be computing for this element here, equals y sup 1, sup 0 plus 1, sup 0, y sup 0 is here, sub 1 is this one right here, so that's a0 minus a2. Minus omega, so that's minus I, times y sup 1 sub 1. Y sup 1 sub 1, a1 minus a3. Okay, so I have here the Fourier transform of A0, A1, A2, A3. You can simplify that a little bit, elementary arithmetic. There's my answer. And just to repeat, you can see in computing these terms right here, when I compute these terms, I end up using all four roots of unity. For n equals 4, I use all four roots. I is the principal root, and then minus 1, and then minus I, and then 1. So those all four roots. Up here, when I'm computing with when I'm computing with the square root, the tooth root, I'm using all two roots, plus 1 and minus 1.